Hello, 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 and welcome to PrivateEnglishPortal.com. My name is Steve Ford, and today we have our Learning English TV Lesson 8. Yes, at Private English Portal, we love talking about love. January went by in the wink of an eye, and it's just a few days before Valentine's Day, so I would like you to remember with me all of the ways that you can say I love you in your language from the beginning sequence of Pepe 28. So let's go.
How do you say I love you?
I love you.
Te quiero.
Ana bahibak. Я люблю тебя.
Мы там все пьяр картон.
Ich schwöre, obichan te.
Ich liebe dich.
Yo te amo.
Seni seviyorum.
Mahal kita.
And you am.
Pohamche.
Je t'aime.
Wo aini.
I stayed it
and you have a car.
Welcome to the funny honeymoon. Welcome to the funny honeymoon. Get into the local tunes, the local players sing to you of better times when love was free and the windy whisper speaks to thee of love.
There are many ways that we can say I love you in English. You can say I'm in love with you. I'm head over heels for you. I'm mad about you. I'm crazy about you. Baby. In fact, that baby, it reminds me when I was working at a school many years ago. They had these tapes and they had these lyrics and you listened to the song with the class and they could follow the lyrics. And the hilarious part about it was that before we listened to the song, there was this voice which read the lyrics of the song. So here you had something very emotional like, baby, I love you forever. And they're saying it in a very mechanical way. Repeat after me. Baby, I love you. La, 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 forever, baby. It was hilarious. And it's a great way to learn English. And that is through the terms of endearment and expressions of love. So my first question is, have you ever fallen in love? As the world spins around faster and faster, and we get caught up in our day-to-day lives, we need something to hold on to. And what a better thing to hold on to than love? It's invisible, it's elusive, but somehow we can feel it, we can touch it, we can taste it. Maybe you have just looked into someone's eyes and it was love at first sight. You could say, I've just seen someone with the most beautiful eyes. Or if you're paying a compliment to somebody that you love, you could say, I really love what you've done to your hair. Last but not least, for the advanced students, and I'll be talking about this a little later, has someone ever broken your heart? Ooh, it's a really difficult question. But it's something that happens to many of us at some point in our lives. So has someone ever broken your heart? Or did someone ever break your heart when you were dating someone in high school, university, or maybe during a first, second, third marriage? Now, heartbreak is no laughing matter, and there are many ways that we can describe how we feel when someone breaks our heart. You can say that you're heartbroken, that you're crushed, that you're shattered, that you're down, that you're crying your eyes out, that you're in a flood of tears. All of these are adjectives and idioms that you can use to describe when you're heartbroken. So actually, you can see that there is so much music. In fact, probably as much music as celebrating love as there is when people break up, when they feel heartbroken, when they feel sad, when they have been rejected by someone that they loved. So we have some pictures here to illustrate my little poem celebrating Valentine's Day, and here we go. Love is gentle whispers in your ear.
Wow, 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 wow.
Love is looking deeply into your eyes. Loves to feel the softness of your hair. Mm. loves a big wet kiss on your mouth. Okay, everybody, that is my lesson on love. I gave you some idioms and vocabulary. I hope that you loved my lesson. I will be giving some grammar explanations at the end of this video. But I have written a song for you. I recorded all of the instruments. I wrote this song for my wife, Leda, on our first Valentine's Day. It's a story about when we were talking on the phone and she saw some butterflies. And when she saw two butterflies together, it gave me the inspiration to write this song. Happy Valentine's Day, and see you next time. Bye-bye.
Into your eyes, I'm in love with your eyes. Have you ever felt the pain of loneliness with so many people by your side? I love the
Okay, here come those grammar points. You stuck around for the end of the class. You can give yourself a pat on the back for that one. Today, we are going to study at an intermediate level first that ever, and I've had a lot of students, even advanced students, who have asked me this, ever is used as an adverb in questions in the present perfect. Have you ever fallen in love? That was one of my questions during the video. Ever does not specify if it's never, rarely or seldom, sometimes, often or frequently, and always. Continuing along the lines of my last lesson, when we were talking about the present perfect, that was on Grouse Mountain where I was skating. You can also add to your list that sometimes you can use the present perfect for the recent past. Many times with just. So you can say, I've just seen the most beautiful eyes. I've just seen the most beautiful woman. In this case, you are actually talking about something which happened in the past very recently. So we're using the present perfect with just in this case. Okay, advanced. This is something that I started to notice only in the last few years that I've been teaching. And that's that you can say, have you ever fallen in love? Or has someone ever broken your heart? As I said in the video. Or you could say, did someone ever break your heart when you were dating someone? So what's the difference here? We have you ever and did you ever? Well, that's strange. I thought that we could only use ever for the present perfect. You can say in a general sense, has someone ever broken your heart in your entire life? Yes, or have you ever fallen head over heels for someone in your entire life? But you could say, did you ever fall in love when you were dating someone? So you're talking more about a specific time period in the past when you use did. How Americans may use the simple past instead of the present perfect. I just had dinner. I've just had dinner. I've already seen that film. I already saw that film. Have you finished your test yet? Did you finish your test yet? Things are starting to change a little bit. So that's something for you to pay attention to, because English is a dynamic language. We used to say, I love it, and many times you can hear in advertising, I'm loving it. So things are changing. Okay, so I hope that you enjoyed my lesson about love, and happy Valentine's Day. Bye-bye.